Hello everyone. In today's lecture, we will discuss an example problem of bisection method. In the last lecture, we discussed in detail what is a bisection method, how this method works, and we also discussed this method works on intermediate value theorem. Okay. In this lecture, we'll take up a simple example problem. Okay. The problem is find a root of an equation. F of x is equal to x cube minus x minus 1 by using bisection method between the interval 0 to 2 up to 2 decimal point accuracy. Okay, so it is a cubic function. We are going to find the root of a cubic function. Okay, and we have given we got some accuracy condition, that is up to 2 decimal point accuracy, means after decimal up to 2 points accuracy you need to continue your iterations, means after decimal 2 digits should be same. Okay, up to that point you should do your iterations. Once you get that accuracy condition, you can stop. Okay, since we cannot do so many number of iterations, suppose it's taking 1000 iterations to reach to the exact root. Okay, so you cannot do it on the paper, so that's why in examination we give this accuracy condition. Okay, but when you use computers, the computers can perform even 1000 operations in just 2 seconds or 1 second because of the nature of the computer. Okay, so in computers we can get the exact root of this function. Okay, when I do the MATLAB videos, very soon I'm going to do videos on MATLAB software, so in that series of lectures I'll also take up the same problem, and you can see that in using software I will find the exact root. Okay, but in this lecture only up to 2 decimal point accuracy we will find the root. Okay, so f of x is the function is x cube minus x minus 1. Lower limit a is 0, upper limit is b is 2. Okay, let's find whether root exists between 0 and 2. So what you should do, you should apply intermediate value theorem. Okay, so find f of 0. F of 0 is, when substitute x equal to 0, you'll get f of 0 is minus 1, that is negative. F of b is f of 2 is 5, that is positive. So when I apply intermediate value theorem, since f of a times f of b is less than 0, because minus 1 times minus 1 times 5 is minus 5, which is less than 0, then you can say root exists between by applying intermediate value theorem, IVT, intermediate value theorem. Since f of 1 times f of 2 is less than 0, you can say root lies between, sorry, f of 0 times f of 2 is less than 0, you can say root lies between 0 and 2. Okay, so now when I apply bisection method, I will halve the interval. Okay, every step I will halve the interval. Okay, I'll find the intermediate value of 0 and 2. So for doing that, I'll find the first approximate of root. First approximate of root, x1 is equal to 0 plus 2 over 2 is equal to 1. That is the intermediate value of 0 and 2. Okay, now I'll find f of x1, that is f of 1. F of 1 is 1 minus 1. That is 0 minus 1, I got minus 1. Okay, so f of 1 is negative, so f of 1 is negative, f of 0 is negative, f of 2 is positive. Understand? So now if I apply intermediate value theorem, f of 0 times f of 1, negative times negative is positive, means greater than 0. So according to intermediate value theorem, root does not exist between 0 and 1. Whereas f of 1 times f of 2, negative times positive is negative. So when I apply intermediate value theorem, root exists between 1 and 2. Okay. So now I'll omit this interval. Now my new interval is 1 and 2. Okay. Not 0 and 2. Now my new interval is 1 and 2. Because and root lies between 1 and 2 only. Okay. So second approximation of root, I'll find the intermediate value of 1 and 2. So 1 plus 2 over 2. So I'll get 3 over 2, that is 1.5. Okay. So f of x2 or f of 1.5 is 0.875, because our f of x is x cube minus x minus 1. So f of 1.5 is 1.5 cube minus 1.5 minus 1. So you'll get 0.875, that is positive. Okay, so f of 1.5 is positive. So f of 1.5 is positive, f of 1 is negative, f of 2 is positive. Okay, so when you apply intermediate value theorem, you can see f of 1 times f of 1.5, negative times positive is negative. So root lies between 1 and 1.5, whereas f of 1.5 times f of 2 is positive times positive is positive. So root does not exist between 1.5 and 2. Root exists between 1 and 1.5. Okay, so in the next step, I will again half this interval. Okay, so third approximation of root, x3 is equal to 1 plus 1.5 over 2, I'll get 1.25. So f of x3, that is f of 1.25, substitute x is equal to 1.25. So you'll get minus 0.2968, which is a negative value. Okay, so f of 1.25 is negative, f of 1 is negative, f of 1.5 is positive. Okay, so f of 1 times f of 1.25, negative times negative is positive. According to intermediate value theorem, root does not exist between 1 and 1.25, whereas f of 1.25 times f of 1.5 is negative times positive, will get negative. So root exists between 1.25 and 1.5. okay, so next step, I'll halve the interval. Okay, so when I halve the interval, I'll get x4, the fourth approximate of root, 1.25 plus 1.5 over 2, I'll get 1.375. so f of 1.375 is again a positive number. Okay, so now when I apply again the intermediate value theorem, I'll get the root lies between f of 1.25 and 1.375. The root lies between the interval 1.25 and 1.375. if you see, after decimal, here I am getting 2, here I am getting 3. Even the first decimal is not same. Okay, so I should do one more iteration. Okay, so fifth root, okay, halving the interval between 1.25 and 1.375, when you halve the interval, you will get 1.3125. So f of x5 or f of 1.3125 is minus 0.05151, which is a negative value. Okay, so if you apply intermediate value theorem, root exists between f of 1.3125 and f of 1.375. so again you should halve this interval. Okay, so when you do that, you'll get sixth approximate of root. So x6 is equal to 1.3125 plus 1.375 over 2, you'll get 1.3435. okay, so f of x6 is 0.08261. you are approaching to zero, but you are not getting here zero. Okay, so this is a positive value. Okay, so positive value. So now when you apply intermediate value theorem, you can find the root exists between the interval 1.3125 and 1.3435. okay, so now I'll have this interval, I'll omit this interval. So when I do that, the seventh approximation of root, x7 is equal to 1.3125 plus 1.34375 over 2, I'll get 1.32812. okay, so f of x7, f of 1.32812 is equal to 0.0145, that is positive. Now when I apply intermediate value theorem, I can say the root lies between f of 1.3125 and f of 1.32812. okay, so now I'll halve this interval to get my next approximation of root. Okay, so when I do a eighth approximation of root, I'll get 1.3125 plus 1.32812 or 2, I got 1.32031. okay, so between the seventh approximation of root and the eighth approximation of root, you can see the after decimal two points are same. So you can stop here. Okay, and you can find f of x side, that is minus 0.01871. Okay, until you get, when you are finding the approximation of root, suppose you got x side, suppose if x side is the exact root, when you substitute f of x side, you should get this value as 0. Okay, until you get 0, you should repeat this process. Okay, but doing on paper is difficult because you may take so many iterations to get the exact value, but in computers you can get the solution very fast. Okay, and since the algorithm is very easy, the algorithm is very simple, many engineers and many softwares uses this algorithm to find the root of a given nonlinear equation. Okay, when I make a lecture series on MATLAB software, again I will come and do this problem in software. Okay, thank you.